And hello, everyone. Randy here. This is Farming Simulator 19. So yes, Farming Sim 19 here. Again, this is early access here at the time I am recording this. So just keep that in mind here. And also, I am still dealing with a pretty good head cold here as well. So if I sound a little funny, that is why. But anyway, let's get started here. If you watched the last live stream over on Twitch there, already got started on the map here. Got Ravenport here set up. Got some equipment to get us started, and we still have $300,000 left there yet. And just to show everyone here what the options are for starting here, you have the option to start as a new farmer. You own some land, some equipment, and they'll teach you how to play. You got farm manager, start with some substantial funds, no land, no buildings, no equipment, up to you what you want to choose. This is the option I went with, by the way. And then you got start from scratch, where it's basically kind of like hard mode essentially there. Starting capital is very limited, and you don't own anything yet, so pretty much the same as farm manager, just not as much money. So anyway, let's go back here. We're going to load up into Ravenport here, and we're going to pretty much pick up where we left off here from the live stream. Again, I am live streaming this over on Twitch. If you'd like to watch more Farming Simulator 19 coverage here, just make sure you head on over there. In fact, when this video goes live, I will probably be either live on Twitch or shortly thereafter live on Twitch. Again, RD Allen on Twitch if you want to watch on Twitch. Okay, so let's start here. You start up in this kind of a forestry area here, I guess. Is this kind of like considered a little starter shack there? Ugh. Anyway, here's the equipment I got so far. Again, if you watched the live stream there, we picked up a John Deere T560i combine. Got an 8-row header to go with that. That is for the sunflowers we have there. Also have the 25-foot grain table as well. Sitting over there. Picked up a John Deere 6155M. As you can tell, yes, we're an all-green farm here. Well, at least as far as the tractors and combine go anyway so far. Got the Kuhn a power harrow for cultivator. Picked up this agro liner for the trailer. Does that hold like 24,000 liters or something like that? I think something. I forget exactly what. But and then we got this five bottom. That was Perlin, right? Not actually sure. Doesn't say what brand it is. Oh, here it is. Agromass? Okay, whatever. Yeah, so it's a five bottom plow. Not a very big plow, but it is five bottom. I guess the other option was to go with a four bottom plow. This five bottom plow takes 180 horsepower, by the way. At least that's what the game claims. And our tractor has, I think it's 164 or something, I think it says in the game there. That's what it claims. And let's just get this out of the way before we get started here. I'm sure everyone wants to see what's in the shop, so let's start there. They definitely have changed up the shop layout here a little bit, and I think definitely for the better. They've definitely divided stuff up a little more. So you got vehicles, then you got tools, you got objects, not a whole lot under objects here, by the way. And then you got placeables, again, not a whole lot under placeables either, but small tractors here. I'm just going to quickly scroll through the list because we want to get started farming here. Not really going to say a whole lot about this, we're just going to scroll through it here real quick. Medium tractors. And then trucks, harvesters, and yes, there's a Case 9240 CR1090 in here as well, by the way. And then, of course, the Ideal Combine. Just three forage harvesters, potato technology, beet technology, a lot of sugar beet technology, and a lot of sugar beet technology. Three different harvesters, actually. Sugarcane, just the one. Cotton, just the one as well. Animals, just two sprayers there. Mowers, just the one mower. Again, for mowers, it's just the one mower because that is a self-propelled mower. There's going to be more mowers under tools. The Ropa Nawa Rohmas. Okay, that's I don't know why that's considered under there. Oh, I guess because it works with all crop types. Okay. That is why. Trailers. Again, I was pointing this out in the live stream. It's too bad there's not any like what I would consider to be a more American-style trailer, that being a gravity wagon, available here for like the smaller farms. Unless you really get up to the big stuff, the Wilson trailer here and the load came really the only what I would consider to be more American-style trailers. But so we got auger wagons. Got a couple nice selection of auger wagons there, headers. There is a 645 flexible drape head for the big combine, by the way. Corn headers, high row corn header. Still questioning that one. All the toe behind the beaten potato technology there. Sugar cane. By the way, there's just the two maps here that have been released for Farming Simulator 19 so far, at least with the edition I have. The North American Ravenport and then the European map as well. The South American map, Estacia La Pocho, has been delayed to my knowledge here. It's still supposed to be coming out as far as I know, just it has been delayed. Yeah, we do have some subsoilers here. Ooh, the coon. Might be worth investigating that. Can be used instead of a plow. I'm not sure if that has to be used with the other coon equipment or if it can be used by itself. Might have to investigate that. Then, of course, we got the big one. 420 horsepower. Yeah, it'll be a while before we have that one. Cedars. So far, we're just starting with small equipment here, by the way. Want to put as much money as I can towards land here first, and then we'll go for equipment. And I need to pick up a fertilizer spreader. Yeah, that's something we need to do. And weeders. That'll, of course, be a part of the game now, by the way. Yeah, not much for mowers. Just that's literally it for the mowers there. Headers, windrowers. Oh, was there more? Yeah, there is actually one more here. The max merge there. A couple different loading wagons, baling technology. Not a whole lot under here, really. You just got, two different round balers and one square baler? Yeah, that's it. You don't even have the New Holland big square baler in here this time. Animal transport. Got the different categories there for front loaders, wheel loaders, telehandlers, skid steer equipment there. One low loader there yet. For trailers. Bunch of different weight selections. Ah, the belts are in here. Okay. I know someone was asking if we'd see the belts or not in Farming Simulator 19. Yes, they are there. Miscellaneous. And not much under the miscellaneous category. Okay, big bags. We got our pig. Oats big bag. Oh, that's for horses, I take it. Okay. Wheat. Seed. Fertilizer. Lime. You don't get a bag of liquid fertilizer. That's going to be under pellets. And okay, fertilizer. Herbicide. Various pellets there. And then, yes, you can buy bales as well. So that's kind of interesting. Different bale types. Interestingly enough, no silage. Square bale yet. That's kind of interesting. Animal pens. Yeah, if you haven't seen how this works, you basically had to place an animal pen down if you want that animal type on your farm. So again, horses, chickens, sheep, pigs, and cows. You got basically a normal one, I guess you could call it, and then a large chicken coop. How big is the large one? Just out of curiosity here. And that's not, yeah, I mean, it's fairly good size, but doghouse. Okay, everyone keeps saying I need to put a doghouse down. Let's, I put this up here in this little, up here somewhere. I don't own this land. Okay, never mind. Let me see if I can put it down here somewhere then. Maybe like over here on the other side of this area here. There we go. One doghouse. Okay. We'll take care of that in a minute here. Miscellaneous, of course, pressure washer, vehicle workshop, water station. Interesting. Silos. I noticed this in the live stream. Yes, with the silos. Seems like they're awfully expensive. Just my opinion, but they seem awfully expensive. Also, bunker silos. Decoration. These buildings, I guess, are pure decoration. And I do like the old barn, but are purely functionless, I guess. A couple sheds. And the farmhouse. The farmhouse lets you sleep and sets your spawn, to my knowledge. Okay, so that's pretty much everything in the shop there. Like I said, just wanted to go through it real quick. I know you folks probably wanted to see that. Oh, hey there. Okay. You folks, you're going to have to help me name. We need a name for the dog. So I'll leave that up for the comments there. Give me a name for the dog. What do we name the dog? Oh, and it comes with a ball too. Here, boy. Oh, come on. Pick up ball. No. Then no interest. No interest. I wonder if we got to get his interest first. He's like, nope, not interested in you. Just feed me. I'm going to go mind my own business. Okay, fine, whatever then. I'm going to go, let's see, what do we want to do? Harvest sunflowers, I guess? I got a field of cotton over here and a field of sunflowers. And then, yeah, if you watched last night's live stream there, this field here, we plowed and cultivated it. So we got cotton fertilized 50%. I wonder if we can put more fertilizer on that. Maybe we should investigate this first. Tools. Go to fertilizing technology here. Oh, I just noticed 24. This is 12. Wow, those are like not very wide at all. It looks like the difference here, though, these can do fertilizer and lime. This can just do fertilizer. So I'm thinking if we're going to do this, we probably want the one that does fertilizer and lime, because we're going to want to do lime as well. We might as well get one that does both, if I'm looking at this correctly. Tensions? Ah. Holds more that way. Why not? That seems like a good one idea to me. I kind of like the big extension. Then, running disc. Meter spreading unit. Does that have to be on it to do the lime, I wonder? Narrow tires. Ugh. Okay, let's do the small extension, standard wheels, spreading discs. Yeah, we'll buy that. We'll go pick this up from the shop here. One thing I will note here with Farming Sim 19 so far, the graphics are wow. Definitely wow on the graphics here. And, of course, again, if you want to see more information on the game here, like I said, follow us over on Twitch there. And we'll definitely be doing lots and lots of live streaming on Farming Simulator 19 here. So, again, probably when this video goes live, I will either be live on Twitch or shortly thereafter. So, like I said, if you want to see more live coverage of Farming Simulator 19 here, like I said, stay tuned on Twitch. If I remember, I'll put a link down in the description there, too. You can click on that, and it'll take you over to the Twitch channel. Trying to drive and blow my nose at the same time here. Not the greatest idea. Still playing with the keyboard here yet. Want to get my steering wheel pulled up. One thing, actually, let's just stop right here. With the steering has really changed big time here in Farming Sim 19. I don't know if it's an option yet. I haven't gone through all the options. But when you go to steer on the keyboard, if I'm steered all the way to the left, notice it doesn't correct back. My hands are off the keyboard. You have to correct the steering manually, so it's manually turn each direction you want to go. So it takes a little getting used to. It's a little more kind of like American Truck Simulator-like steering, if you will. The steering is not like super fast. And then, of course, if you want it to turn back, you got to turn it back. Kind of the way it was with the tractor anyway, if you ask me, but... Again, if you can't tell already, the graphics are really, really good on here so far. And I suppose while we're here, we probably should figure out how to fill this up and where to fill it up yet. But that just occurred to me. I have not done anything with that yet. Okay. Now, do I have to have the big bags, or is there a place I can fill this up on the map, I wonder? Because there wasn't really any options for... Let's go under placeables here. I don't think there was any options here that I recall. Silos. So I think we're pretty much stuck with using big bags, aren't we? Okay, well, let's just buy one of these here a minute. Am I going to have to lift this up to get this in here? Probably aren't I? Oh, no, I don't have to. Okay, good. Yeah, I'm going to need more. Okay. It'd be nice if there was like an option here to buy multiples. That would be nice. Okay, 4,000 liters worth. That should be enough, right, to get started. Not sure. How much does this actually hold here again? I didn't even look at that when we bought it. Fertilizer technology, does it say? With the extension we have, it holds... Oh, 11,000. Oh, wow. So it holds quite a bit here. Yeah, spreading width isn't quite so nice on it. You know, 12 meters versus... we went with actually the smaller one at 24, but oh well. Okay, let's see how long that lasts us here. I think we'll definitely have to find a way to get some seed and fertilizer down at our farmyard here as well. Just going in cab here. Again, the cab view is really good looking. They definitely put a lot of detail into the cab here. I don't believe there's anything like IC controls or anything like that, by the way. Not in-game, anyway. I don't think you can interact with any of the controls in the cab. And, of course, at this point, my favorite mod is not available for the game yet. So, yeah, all manual steering here, which is kind of silly when you think about it, because given this type of application here with fertilizer, that is typically where a GPS is probably most commonly used, even by smaller farmers. They will have some form of GPS that lets them do fertilizer and spraying type applications, at least if they do it themselves. You know what? Crops are already on the field here. Probably an application where I need narrow tires, but oh well. See if this works. Sort of lines up with the rows. Does it actually do anything? I can't tell. Maybe when the crops are growing, this doesn't work anymore. I'm not sure. No, I don't think that changed. Okay, so I wasn't sure if you could still fertilize crops or not. They might have changed that now, so when your crops are growing, it's too late. My only complaint with that, of course, is then when you buy a field, you know, typically a field like this, they don't come fertilized or fully fertilized, so that's always kind of annoying. You definitely lose out on a lot of yield that way. Let's try this over on the field we do own over here that is just cultivated and see how this works over here. Now, I do have all the options turned on as far as lime and plowing and fertilizing. I do have all that on. The other thing I don't have on, though, is crop destruction. Ew, this is working. I definitely can't see it. Interesting. So how do you tell if this is fertilized or not? Because it's not, most definitely not doing anything, is it? Well, might have to investigate this further then. Load. Oh, can unload it too. Interesting. Okay. Honk. Yep, nice little sounding tractor horn there. And of course, if I can't see the spread width here, like I said, I don't think this is actually doing anything. Something is apparently wrong. If I'm doing something wrong here or what. Oh, look out for the sunflowers. Really quick. Actually, you know what? Let's just drive into this here a little bit. Notice how the sunflowers bend over here when we drive through them. That is really cool. And, of course, if I had crop destruction on, it would actually destroy him as well. I wonder, can I not put this on a cultivated field? That doesn't make any sense, though, because that, depending on the farmer, you know, typically either, you know, you can put it on before plowing, after plowing, after cultivating, then cultivate it again. So yeah, this should definitely be working. I wonder if the field, does the field have to be planted to fertilize it? That would seem kind of odd. I'll have to look into this a little bit further. Actually, you know what? I wonder if the game says. There is a help menu. Investigate this here a minute. Saving content. Oh, there is autosave, by the way. Where was that again? That was under, was it this one? Yes. There's the autosave function there. So every 15 minutes, it does autosave. A really nice feature. Definitely been needed in the game for a long time. There's, of course, been mods that have taken care of that, but still. Let's see what's here. Where do we have, anything on fertilizing? Production recap. Okay. Lime and herbicide for fertilizers. Digestate can also be produced. Okay. Doesn't really tell you like how we can use it though, does it? Interesting. Okay. Guess we'll have to figure it out. Like I said, something doesn't seem like it's working quite right there because I don't see any fertilizer on this field. The tooltip doesn't say we did anything with... Oh, wait, fertilized, 100%. Oh, okay. No, it is too fertilized. Okay. Did I miss that? Was it fertilized before? Maybe it was fertilized before, and that's why it's not showing up. Well, anyway, let's get started here. I wanted to do some harvesting here. And, oh, wow. It's already that time in the episode here. 26 minutes into the episode here already. Well, let's... yeah, we'll make like a pass on the harvester here, and then we'll have to wrap it up. I just got the 8-row row crop header on here. Oh, yeah. Looks like they definitely did a nice job with the animations here. Field textures seem to be about the same, by the way. The crop textures, I think they maybe improved the crop textures a little bit. But as far as, like, the textures on the field go, they look like they're about the same. I can't really tell any difference between the textures here in the field from 17 to 19 here. Where's our fill percentage? Okay, down in the bottom there, right next to our HUD information. 600 liters of sunflowers in there so far. Again, I got to get used to going back to liters here. I was just starting to get used to going to the bushels there using the unit convert mod in 17, but that obviously is not out here for 15 or for 19 yet. Also, did I note there's no GPS mod? Did I make note of that? And there's no GPS built into the game either. It's not going to take long to harvest this field, is it? I do have the cotton field there. What I'm thinking I'm going to do is I'm going to plant all three of these fields in cotton here, and then we'll go ahead and lease a cotton harvester to at least make it worth it, because just that one small field there, I don't think it's going to be worth it to harvest a cotton for just that one field and lease a harvester for it. I think it was about 40,000. Oop. Right, gotta remember. Gotta straighten out the steering here. Don't think it's going to be worth, to lease a cotton harvester for just one field. So, in fact, probably all three fields here probably still won't be worth it. But at least for three fields worth it, should be at least a little more worth it. Anyway, like I was saying there, everyone, we got to wrap it up here. So, yes, if you have any comments or questions, be sure to leave them below. And don't forget, Farming Simulator 19 comes out on November 19th, at 6:01 p.m. Eastern Standard Time Zone. So, again, whatever time zone that is for you. So, November 19th at 6 p.m. Eastern Standard Time Zone. Again, keep in mind, we are live streaming or will be live streaming over on Twitch here for more coverage of Farming Simulator 19. So if you want to see more, head on over there. You got some questions to ask, comments to make. Well, like I said, you can watch it live there. Try to show a little more. If you got questions, like I said, we'll try to go through it. So again, thanks for watching and until next time.